Is it okay for a husband to demand respect from his wife in Islam? Yes. But the Quran says, as I said in my talk in Surah Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 187, Hunna libasul lakum, wantum libasul lahunna. That they are your garments and you are your garments. Wives are the garments of husbands, and the husbands are the garments of the wives. In the same way, even the husband should respect the feeling and emotions of the wife. It's both. Both should respect each other. Can a brother marry more than one wife, even if he cannot afford to maintain one in a reasonable standard? The reasonable standard of each individual differs. One individual may say reasonable standard means I want at least 5-bedroom apartment, I want a Mercedes car. The reasonable standard differs. What the Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse number 3, that marry women of a choice in 2s, 3s and 4s. But if you can't do justice, marry one. The criteria is doing justice. If you have one Mercedes car, and if you feel the requirement is marry one more, sell the Mercedes car and buy 2 Toyota cars and give each wife one. Sell the 5-bedroom apartment and get 2-bedroom apartments and give each wife one, or keep both the wives in 5-bedroom apartment. The criteria is equal justice. Reasonable standard differs. That doesn't mean, if you mean reasonable standard means a particular, he should have a certain amount, that means poor people cannot marry more than one wife. That's not the criteria. I'm sure the Muslims will agree that only deen acceptable to Allah is Islam, and that it is incorrect to say that no religion is bad. I do agree. The Quran says in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse number 19, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The only religion acceptable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. And I do agree totally. If anyone says no religion is bad and stops there, I don't agree with him. As a Muslim, I don't agree with him. Because Quran says in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse number 64, Ta'ala wila kalmitin sawa'im bainana bainakum. Come to common terms as between us and you. What I would say that all religions teach good things. Because every religion teaches good and bad things except Islam. Teaches only good. So instead of saying no religion is bad, if you want to come to common terms, I would say all religions teach good things. First talk about the good points between both the religions and then come to the bad points. What you can say, no religion teaches everything bad. That you can say. But you can't only say no religion is bad and stop that, trying to butter the other person. Because Quran clearly states in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 85 that no religion would be acceptable on the side of Allah except Islam. If anyone demands any other religion besides Islam, it will never be accepted on him on the day of judgment. Is it true that Jesus will come back, and do Christians believe this? Yes, we do agree. The Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 158 that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him up alive. So we agree he was raised up alive. And the reason that he was raised up alive is why? Because Jesus, peace be upon him, is the only messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whose followers mistook him that he claimed divinity. They misunderstood him, that he claimed divinity, that he said he was God. So he has been raised up not to teach anything new. The Quran says in Surah Maidah chapter 5 verse number 3, on this day have I perfected my religion for you and chosen for you Islam and completed your deen for you. Islam is complete. Nothing new can be added, nothing can be subtracted. Isa alayhi salam will not come to teach anything new. He will come to tell the Christians that I never said that I was God. As the Quran says in Surah Maidah chapter number 5 verse number 116, he will tell to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you be my witness. I never told them to worship me, but I said, A'budullah, worship Allah, Rabbi wa Rabbakum, who is my Lord and your Lord. Similar message given in the Bible. On that day when people will come and tell to Jesus, peace be upon him, oh my Lord, did we not do wonders and miracles? Jesus will say, ye men of iniquity, you depart from here, I don't even know you. Who will he tell? To the Muslims? To the Hindus, he'll tell to the Christians that these sinful people, I don't even know, you depart from here. He will come again to correct the Christian, not to bring any new teachings. Please explain the advent mention of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Bible. Does the Bible prophesy the advent of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? There's 2 questions. There are several prophecies of beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Bible. Old Testament as well as New Testament. It's mentioned in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, that God says, I shall raise thee up a prophet from among thy brethren, like unto thee, and I shall put my words into his mouth, and he shall say all that I command him. Christians say that this prophecy refers to Jesus, peace be upon him. But if you analyze, that Jesus was unlike Moses, peace be upon him. What they say, that see, because Jesus was a Jew and he was a prophet, he was like Moses, peace be upon him. If these two are the only criteria to fulfill the prophecy, then all the prophets mentioned in the Bible after Moses, peace be upon him, Solomon, Ezekiel, Isaiah, Daniel, Hosea, John, all of them fulfilled the prophecy because they were Jew and they were prophets of God. If you analyze this prophecy, it fits no one but a beloved Prophet Muhammad, because both Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon him, they had a natural birth. Unlike Jesus, peace be upon him. Muhammad and Moses, peace be upon them, both. they were married their children. Jesus, peace be upon him, did not have. Both of them, they died a natural death. Jesus, peace be upon him, he didn't die a natural death. According to the Quran, he was raised up alive, in according to the Bible. But the false reading of Christian, they say that he was put on the cross. And there are more similarities between Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Musa alaihi salam than Isa alaihi salam and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Further, it says, from among their brethren, and we know that the Arabs are brethren of the Jews. Again, if you read the book of Isaiah, chapter number 12, verse number 29, it says that a prophet shall come who's not learned, and it will be said to him, pray, read this, and he will say, I'm not learned. When the first revelation came to our beloved prophet Iqra, Surah Iqra, chapter 96, verse number 1, when Archangel Gabriel said, Iqra, our prophet said, Ma ana biqari, I'm not learned. Exactly befitting the prophecy. Even the name of the prophet is mentioned in the Old Testament in the Song of Solomon, chapter number 5, verse number 16. In Hebrew, it is said, "Hikma mitakim wi kulli Muhammadim, Zaydudi wa Zairai baina Jerusalem." Muhammadim, im is added for respect in the Semitic languages, in the Hebrew language. Muhammad, im, Muhammadim. Im is respect, it's actually Muhammad. With respect, im, it's called Muhammadin. But the translate as, his mouth is more sweet, he's altogether lovely. He's my beloved, he's my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. But the original manuscript contained the word of Muhammad in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, if you refer to the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 16, Gospel of John, chapter number 15, verse number 26, it says about the coming of the beloved prophet as a comforter. It said in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 7, that, nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the comforter shall not come. For if I depart, shall I send him. The Christians say that this comforter is the Holy Spirit. But the criteria here is that the comforter shall come only if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, departs. I knew that the Holy Spirit was already there in Elizabeth. It was there when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was born, when he was being baptized. So this prophecy cannot refer to the Holy Spirit. It refers to our beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Further, if you read in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, it says, I have many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you to all truths. All the prophets prophesy the coming of another prophet and the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, except the last and final messenger. And I have given a talk on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the various world religious scriptures, in Hindu scriptures, Buddhist scriptures, and Parsi scriptures, Jewish scriptures, Christian scriptures. You can refer to the cassette for details. Is temporary marriage allowed in Islam? Please, I know Muslims who believe in it, explain. Okay, the time is up. If you're referring to Muta, it's not allowed at all. Agreed, previously a prophet didn't say it was wrong, didn't say it was yes, because some prohibitions came in stages, like the alcohol came in stages. Similarly, the prophet didn't say anything, but in the 7th Hijri, during the Tabuk expedition, the prophet clearly stated that muta is haram. The other question is time permits, inshallah.
Thank you very much to all the speakers and to everyone attending. Can I just ask for a little bit of help? As you go out, can you just stack some chairs as you go out, just two or three at a time, and it'll make the whole job a lot easier for us. Thanks very much indeed. Is there a father in this world?